So blood glucose is the glucose is the petrol for our body. Glucose is like petrol for our body. So it undergoes oxidation in the body by glycolysis pathway and uric acid cycle, and it yields energy to the body cells. So this is the major energy supply to the body cells. Maintenance of blood glucose at normal range is a very difficult task. So how it is maintained, that we are going to study in this topic actually. So two terms you should remember: hyperglycemia, hypoglycemia. Hyperglycemia, hyperglycemia, mia means M-I-A. Hyperglycemia means increased blood glucose concentration is called hyperglycemia. Hypoglycemia means decreased blood glucose concentration. Decreased blood glucose concentration is called hypoxemia. That you should remember. Now, two hormones are responsible for the maintenance of the blood glucose in the body. That is hypoglycemic hormones and hyperglycemic hormones. Hypoglycemic hormones and hyperglycemic hormone. Hypoglycemic hormone is insulin in our body. Hypoglycemic hormone is insulin in our body. Hyperglycemic hormone is glucagon, epinephrine, cortisol, growth hormone, ACTH. Like this, there are some other hormones are also there. They are comes under examples of hyperglycemic hormone. Hyperglycemic hormone. So hypoglycemic hormone means what it will do, this will decreases the blood glucose concentration. So insulin is a hypoglycemic hormone, is produced in response to the increased blood glucose concentration, means hyperglycemia. In response to hyperglycemia, insulin is produced in the body. So what it will do, it will clears the glucose from the blood by increasing glycolysis pathway, citric acid cycle pathway. So as a result, glucose is oxidized in glycolysis and citric acid, and the concentration of glucose in the blood decreases. So that is why it is called hypoglycemic hormone. Insulin is decreasing the blood glucose concentration. It is produced when in response to the hyperglycemia, means increased blood glucose concentration. So after the heavy meal, what will happen? We take food. So and it undergoes digestion. After a heavy meal, what will happen? The blood glucose concentration is increased because the diet contains a lot of carbohydrate. So blood glucose concentration is increased after a heavy meal. So what will happen? Before it increasing more than the threshold value, the insulin is produced in response to the hyperglycemia. As a result, insulin, what it will do, it stimulates the body cells to carry out the glycolysis pathway and citric acid cycle. So glucose is oxidized, is utilized in the body and releases the energy. And the glucose concentration in the blood comes down by the action of insulin. That is why it is called as hypoglycemic hormone. If you see the hyperglycemic hormones, like glucagon, epinephrine, cortisol, growth hormone, they are produced in response to the hypoglycemia condition. Hypoglycemia means decreased blood glucose concentration. Because of the activity of insulin, the glucose is exhausted from the body by glycolysis and citric acid cycle. So the blood glucose concentration decreases than the normal level. That condition is called hypoglycemia. So in response to the hypoglycemia, hyperglycemic hormones like glucagon, epinephrine, cortisol and growth hormone are produced in the body. And what they do? They increase the blood glucose concentration to the normal level. So since they are responsible for increase in the blood glucose concentration to normal level, they are called as hyperglycemic hormones. So insulin is a hypoglycemic hormone. Glucagon, epinephrine, cortisol and growth hormone are hyperglycemic hormones So what you have to do is, origin of glucose, homeostasis and major fuel of brain. So origin of blood glucose, I told food. So food. Now see this diagram. So in this diagram you can see the blood glucose, how it is coming into the blood, glucose how it comes into the blood and how it is utilized from in the body is shown here. Now see, dietary carbohydrates consists of starch, sucrose, glucose. They undergo digestion and they are absorbed in the intestine, and the glucose is absorbed from the intestine and reaches the liver. So in the from the liver it enters into the blood circulation. The blood circulation, fasting blood glucose concentration or FBS, is normal range is 70 to 100 or 60 to 100 milligrams per deciliter is also okay. Okay, 60 to 100 or 70 to 100 milligrams per deciliter is the fasting blood glucose concentration. So always the fasting blood glucose concentration in a healthy individual, it is maintained at 70 to 100 milligrams per deciliter. Postprandial blood glucose concentration means after a heavy meal, that is called PPBS. After a heavy meal, after 2 hours of heavy meal, that is called PPBS, postprandial blood sugar, PPBS value. So the PPBS value is about 120 to 140 milligrams per deciliter. 120 to 140 milligrams per deciliter. There is another blood normal range is also there, blood glucose normal range, that is RBS, capital letters. R means random, B blood sugar, BS means blood sugar. Random blood sugar is about 120 to 130 milligrams per deciliter. 120 to 130 milligrams per deciliter is called random blood sugar. So random blood sugar means anytime you can collect the blood sample. Fasting means fasting blood sugar, you have to collect the fasting blood sugar only after a overnight fasting of 8 to 10 hours. Minimum 8 to 10 hours of fasting should be there for doing the fasting blood sample. Postprandial means after meal 2 hours of blood glucose. After meals 2 hours, after the 2 hours of heavy meal, the blood is collected and tested for glucose, then that value is called PPBS value, means postprandial blood sugar. Random means anytime you collect the blood sugar, blood and test for the glucose, that is called random blood sugar. Okay, so now this is the normal blood glucose range, fasting 70 to 100, PPBS 120 to 140 milligrams per deciliter. So this has to be maintained normally all the time in the body. So glucose comes from the diet, and glycogen is stored in the form of glucose is stored in the form of glycogen in the muscle and in the liver. So this glycogen in the muscle undergoes degradation because of muscle activity. It is converted to lactate, and lactate via gluconeogenesis means gluconeogenesis means synthesis of glucose from non-carbohydrate sources in the body is called gluconeogenesis. So via gluconeogenesis, it converted into the glucose and enters into the blood circulation. Similarly, there are some amino acids and glycerol, propionate, they are all converted into glucose via gluconeogenesis pathway. And glycogenolysis, the body has got glycogen stores in the body, and glycogen undergoes breakdown in fasting condition. So what will happen? Free glucose is liberated from the glycogen. So likewise, glycogen also contributes to the glucose that enters into the blood. So this glucose, this is how it enters into the blood. Now how this glucose is utilized by the body? So glucose is utilized by the body by glycolysis pathway and TCA cycle. So in glycolysis and TCA cycle, glucose is oxidized to carbon dioxide and water and releases the energy. Similarly, glucose from the blood is utilized for glycogenesis. Excess glucose is converted into glycogen and stored in the liver, kidney and muscles. Then glucose, synthesis of other monosaccharides and amino sugars utilized. Glucose is utilized for the synthesis of other monosaccharides like galactose, mannose. It is also used for the synthesis of amino sugars like glucosamine. Then glucose is required, oxidized in alternative oxidative pathway called HMP shunt pathway. And HMP shunt is required for the production of pentose sugars in the body. So NADPH is also produced in HMP pathway. HMP pathway is an alternative oxidative pathway for the glucose. Then glucose is, excess glucose is used for the synthesis of fat. So this is how excess glucose is utilized from the body. So this side, entry points for the glucose into the blood. This side, exit points for the glucose, means exit points means utilization of blood glucose. So down it is mentioned the sources of blood glucose. So this is how the glucose comes into the blood, and this side is the utilization of blood glucose. So glucose is utilized in the body for various functions by the body cells. Okay, so this is the summary is mentioned here. During this incoming and utilization process, all the time the blood glucose should be maintained at a normal range, that is FBS means 70 to 100 milligrams, or PPBS means 120 to 140 milligrams per deciliter. So this has to be maintained at a constant normal range. So for this there are hormones in the body, that is hypoglycemic hormone and hyperglycemic hormones. Hypoglycemic hormone is insulin, hyperglycemic hormone is glucagon, cortisol, growth hormone. Okay, so these two hormones, they counteract each other in response to the blood glucose levels. Okay, so blood glucose is regulated by the hormones called hypoglycemic hormone and hyperglycemic hormones. That is what we are going to study now. So it is because of the demands of the brain for glucose that human body regulates the level of glucose circulating in the blood. Nearly all carbohydrates ingested in the diet are converted to glucose following transport to the liver. Now, catabolism of dietary or cellular proteins generates carbon atoms that can be utilized for glucose synthesis via gluconeogenesis. Now, other tissues that incompletely oxidize glucose provide lactate that can be converted to glucose via gluconeogenesis. Maintenance of blood glucose homeostasis is of paramount importance for the survival of the human beings. Maintenance of blood glucose homeostasis is of paramount importance for the survival of the human beings. The predominant tissue responding to signals that indicate reduced or elevated blood glucose levels is the liver. Now, one of the most important functions of the liver is to produce glucose for the circulation. So both elevated and reduced levels of blood glucose trigger hormonal response to initiate pathways designed to restore glucose homeostasis. So both elevated means increased and reduced levels means decreased levels of blood glucose trigger hormonal response to initiate the pathways designed to restore the glucose homeostasis. Okay, so any decrease in the normal blood glucose level or increase in the blood glucose level stimulates these hormones, and these hormones, they give instructions to the body cells to restore the glucose homeostasis by various pathways. Low blood glucose triggers release of glucagon from pancreatic alpha cells. Low blood glucose means decreased blood glucose triggers the release of hormone called glucagon. This glucagon hormone is produced by the pancreatic alpha cells, islets of Langerhans of alpha cells present in the pancreatic gland produces the glucagon. So this glucagon further directs the body cells to maintain the glucose level to normal range by increasing the gluconeogenesis, glycogenolysis. The glucose is brought to the normal condition, whereas high blood glucose concentration stimulates the production of insulin, triggers the production of insulin. This insulin hormone is produced by the same pancreatic gland, but the cells are beta cells. Alpha cells of the pancreas of islets of Langerhans produces the hormone glucagon, whereas islets of Langerhans beta cells produces the hormone insulin. Both glucagon and insulin hormone are produced by the pancreatic cells, but the cells are different. Alpha cells produce glucagon, whereas beta cells produce insulin. These two hormones act antagonistic to each other. Similarly, additional signals stimulates the production of ACTH and growth hormone. These hormones released from the pituitary gland, they act to increase blood glucose by inhibiting uptake by extrahepatic tissues. So it gives these extrahepatic tissues a signal that don't take glucose, don't use much glucose. So as a result, what will happen? Glucose will be retained in the blood. Then glucocorticoids also act to increase blood glucose levels, like cortisol is able to increase the blood glucose level by inhibiting the glucose uptake. Then cortisol is a major glucocorticoid released from the adrenal cortex. Is secreted in response to the increase in circulation of ACTH. So as a result, a decreased blood glucose is brought to the normal condition. Now, adrenal medullary hormone epinephrine also stimulates the release of glucose into the circulation by activating glycogenolysis. Glycogenolysis means breakdown of glycogen and release of free glucose takes place in glycogenolysis. So this activation of glycogenolysis produces free glucose, so glucose comes into the blood circulation. Now glucagon bindings to its receptors on the surface of liver cells triggers an increase in cyclic AMP production, leading to an increased rate of glycogenolysis. So as a result, breakdown of glycogen takes place in the liver and releases the free glucose into the circulation, blood circulation. As a result, decreased blood glucose will come to the normal glucose level. So the result of these hyperglycemic hormones is increased levels of glucose in the increased levels of free glucose that enters into the circulation. Okay, so this is what the action of hyperglycemic hormones. In opposition to the cellular responses to glucagon and epinephrine on liver cells, hepatocytes means liver cells, insulin stimulates extrahepatic uptake of glucose from the blood and inhibits glycogenolysis in extrahepatic cells and conversely stimulates glycogen synthesis. So excess glucose is diverted for the synthesis of glycogen by the action of insulin. So these two hormones, what they do? These two hormones act antagonistic to each other and they try to maintain the blood glucose concentration at the same level, at the normal level. Now see, this is the reading showing the blood glucose concentration. It is 40 milligrams, 50, 60 milligrams, 70 milligrams, 80, 90 and so on. The scale is like this, 50, 40 to 120. Is given the scale, blood glucose scale here, but normal fasting blood glucose range is 70 to 100 milligrams per deciliter and PPBS normal range is about 120 to 140 milligrams per deciliter and 180 is renal threshold blood glucose. If blood glucose concentration increases more than 180, then it will start excreted in urine. That condition is called glycosuria. So hypoglycemic hormone, that is insulin. What insulin will do? Insulin is produced in response to increased blood glucose concentration. Increased blood glucose concentration is usually seen in the after a heavy meal. After a heavy meal, glucose concentration is increased in the blood. As a result, insulin is produced. This is a hypoglycemic effect hormone. So what it will do? This insulin clears the glucose from the blood by promoting increasing the glucose uptake by the body cells. It increases the glycolysis pathway. It increases the glycogen synthesis pathway. Glycogenesis means glycogen synthesis pathway. It increases the HMP pathway for the production of pentose sugars and NADPH production. It increases the production of lipids. So excess glucose is diverted for the synthesis of fatty acids. So insulin increases the lipid synthesis. At the same time, insulin decreases the gluconeogenesis, means production of glucose from non-carbohydrate sources is called gluconeogenesis. Insulin decreases or inhibits this gluconeogenesis. Similarly, insulin decreases or inhibits glycogenolysis. Glycogenolysis means breakdown of glycogen in the body. So insulin inhibits glycogenolysis and gluconeogenesis, whereas it promotes glucose uptake, increases the glycolysis cycle, increases the glycogenesis, increases the HMP pathway, and increases the lipid synthesis. As a result, blood glucose concentration is decreased. So increased blood glucose concentration because of the action of insulin, it comes to normal range or it may decrease further. So the hypoglycemic effect is there now because of the action of insulin. So immediately counteracting hormones like hyperglycemic effect hormones, they are secreted in the body by pancreas, that is glucagon, and pituitary hormone also produces the glucocorticoids, growth hormone and ACTH. As a result, these hyperglycemic hormones like glucagon, what it will do, glucagon will increases the gluconeogenesis, means increased production of glucose by other non-carbohydrate sources, and it also increases glycogenolysis, means breakdown of glycogen. Then other hormones also, they increase the gluconeogenesis and glycogenolysis. As a result, glucose is produced from the glycogen, enters into the circulation. Now decreased glucose concentration will come to the normal level. So any fluctuation in the blood glucose concentration in the body causes the hormone release, and the blood glucose homeostasis is maintained by the hormones. So this is how hormonal regulation of blood glucose takes place.